Hello friends, welcome to the Technical Study Place YouTube channel. In this video, we will learn about beam penetration technique. So, before we start this, I would like to recommend you to see my previous videos of what is CRT and how it works, and another two videos, that is vector scan display and raster scan display. And if you want, you can also see the video of pixel. So you will get a better idea how this works. So we have seen that how the vector scan display and how the raster scan display works. So we will apply the voltage to that pins, and the electrons will come and strike it on the screen. So like that, how we look at the image on the screen, like wherever we want, on that particular area only the image will be generated on the screen in vector scan display. But whereas in raster scan display, it will scan line by line through pixels. This the CRT screen is of pixels na, so it will scan line by line. So according to zeros and ones, where there is zero, there will be no there is no image generation, because no zero means nothing to print. But whereas one, something, some information is there, that will, it will be print according to the information, the image will be generated on the screen. So let's come to here. In the color CRT monitors, we have a concept of beam penetration technique. So we're going to beam penetration technique. So let's see about some color CRT monitors. So let's learn some 2-3 points about that. So the normal CRT can generate images of single color due to limitations of phosphor coating. Means whatever the CRT screen is there, means CRT is there, in that phosphor screen is there, that in that inside only one layer of coating will be there. So basically it is sometimes white, basically it is of white layer only. So basically it is of only one color of white, one color of coating will be there inside the CRT screen. Okay, it generates a range of colors by combining the emitted light from multi-layered phosphor coated color CRT. But in case here color CRT monitors, what will happen? So we'll combine the colors, means many colors, more than one colors, either maybe to have two colors, three colors, we can call it as multi-layered colors. So not one color, more than one color. So it may be two color, three color layer will be there inside the phosphor screen. So let me show you some diagram so you will have the quick idea. So this is the diagram of beam penetration technique. You can see here, this is the phosphor screen. Okay, so here inside layers will be there. So this is one layer, this is one layer. So one color is one layer, and this is another color, so it is another layer. So basically it is two layer, means multi-layer is there. Okay, in the phosphor screen. Okay, so in the CRT, normal CRT, what will happen? Only one color will be there. So one color will be generated on the screen. Basically if you talk about the vector scan display, so basically if we pass the electrons, then obviously if the only one color is there in the phosphor screen, so only one layer coating will be there, means so obviously when the electrons will come strike, so only that color image will be generated, only one color image will be generated in the vector scan display. But whereas here in the color CRT monitors, we have multi-layered color in the phosphor screen, more than one color. So this is of color CRT monitors. Okay, it generates of colors combining the emitted light from the multi-layered phosphor coated color CRT. Means in the CRT we have multi-layered colors, more than one color. So it is of the color CRT monitors. So let's go next. There are basic two techniques used for producing color display. So to produce color, we have basically two techniques. One is beam penetration technique and another one is shadow mask technique. So in this video we will see about the beam penetration technique. Okay, beam penetration technique is used with random scan display where CRT is coated with of two layer of phosphor, usually red and green. Okay, So in the beam penetration technique is used with random scan display. So whatever the beam penetration technique is there, this technique is used with random scan display where CRT coated with of two layers. You can see here the CRT, this is the CRT. So it is of coated with two layers, one layer and another layer. Okay, two layers of usually red and green. So first one is red and green. So this red is one layer and green is another layer. The CRT screen and the CRT is of coated with two layer. The one is red and another is green in the phosphor screen. Okay, outer layer is red phosphor and inner layer is green phosphor. So outer layer is what? Red phosphor, you can see here. So this is the green phosphor and it is the phosphor screen. Outside it is phosphor screen, but inside green and red phosphor is there. Okay, color depends how far the electron beam penetrates into phosphor screen. So what it is telling means what color we get in the output of the screen. So basically here two colors are there. So what color we get in the output of the screen? See, when we produce the voltage or current in the pins, so the heater will get heat up and it will produce the electrons. Okay, and the electron beam come here and strike it on the screen. Okay, how far it strikes on the screen means how deep the electrons come and strike it on the screen, like that it will generate the color on the phosphor screen. Okay, so if the how far means how penetrates means how deep the electrons goes inside the layer, so like that on basis of that the color will be generated on the screen. Okay, so penetrates means how inside the electron is going. Okay, how inside the electron is going, like that the electron, the color will be generated on the screen. How far how inside the electron going inside the layer, these two layers, so that type of color will be generated on the phosphor screen. Okay, so low electron beam speed strike only red phosphor, thus produces red rays on screen. Means when we produce some voltage, high voltage on the pins, so what will happen? So the heater will get heat up, it produces high speed the electrons, and the electrons will come in forcefully because we have produced the high voltage. So the electrons will come at speed and if we produce some low voltage, so first we will talk about low voltage, then we talk about high speed. Okay, so if we produce some low voltage to the pins, so what will happen? It produces the electrons, the heater will get heat up and it produces the electrons. The heater will coming in slow because we have produced some low voltage, so the electrons will come and strike it on the screen. It will not go deep inside the electrons, but just to come and strike it on the screen. Just now we have seen that the first layer is of red and the second layer is of green. After that, phosphor screen is there. Inside the layers will be there. The first one is red and the second one is green. So the electrons beam is coming and striking on the screen. So you should remember that the electrons are low speed, means the speed is low and the electrons are coming at strike it on the screen. So obviously which color the electrons will touch? At which color the electrons will strike? Obviously the red color, because the red color is first. So the electrons, because of the electrons speed is slow, it will not penetrate the electron, means the electrons will not go deeper inside, just the electrons come and strike it on the red layer because the electron speed is low. Okay, because of this reason the electrons traces the red traces will be on the phosphor screen, because the electron speed is low, because it is striking on the only the red layer, the electron is not penetrating, means the electron is not going inside, so it is not touching the green layer, only it is coming and striking on the red layer because the electron's speed is low. So because of this reason it is touching only red layer, so because of this reason it will strike only red traces on the phosphor screen. So what happens when the electron beam is high? So high electron beam penetrates into green phosphor and produces and green traces. So if we produce high voltage or high current to the pins, so the heater will get more heat up and it produces the speed electrons, means the high electron, the electrons will get, and the heater will get heat up and it produces the electrons. So because of the high voltage, the electrons will come in the speed, very high speed. So what will happen? So the if the electrons are come here, and if the electrons is in speed, the electrons come here and it will penetrate, means it will go deeper inside. The if the electrons are coming here, it will go inside of the red and it touches the green layer. Okay, because of the electron speed is high, electrons coming and penetrating, so means penetrating means the electron is going deeper inside. So the electron is going inside of the red and touching the green layer. So because of this reason, the green traces will be shown in the output of the screen, means in the phosphor screen. Because of the high voltage, the electrons coming in the faster speed, fast electrons is coming, so it is the electrons of is coming fast, so the electrons is what it is doing, it is penetrating, means it is going deeper inside. So it is deeper inside means what is the last layer in this here, the green is the last layer. So because of the speed electrons, because of the fast electrons, the electrons are going deeper, means that it is going first going to the red layer, and after that it is going to the green layer, it touches the green layer. So because of this reason, because of the fast electron, we get the traces of green traces. Okay, if we produce the electron as medium speed, then what will happen? Medium electron beam produces colors of combination of red and green, like orange and yellow. Means if they produce medium voltage, so medium voltage, then what will happen? The electrons come in medium voltage, mean at medium speed, then come and strike it on the screen. So because of the medium speed, the electrons come and strike it on the screen, so we'll get the combination of colors. So combination of colors means the red and blue colors combination we get. Whatever the combination we get, that color will strike it on the screen. So basically that will be of two colors, that is, one is orange and yellow. Okay, so what will happen when we give high voltage to the pins, the electrons coming in the speed. So if the electrons are coming in the speed and strike it on the screen, if the electrons are coming in the speed, the electrons will penetrate, means go inside, going deeper. So it will touch to the green layer. First it will go inside the red layer and touches the green layer, because the electron speed is very much high. So we get the green traces. If the electron speed is less, means if we give less voltage, then electrons come in slow. So it only strikes on the red layer, because the first is the red layer. So it does not go deeper inside. It does not touch the green layer, because the electron speed is very slow. So the red traces will be found in red traces we get in the phosphor screen, because it touches only the red layer, because the electron speed is low. If we pass some medium voltage, then what will happen? Then electrons come and strike it on the screen. So we get the combination of these two colors, red and green, of combination of two colors in the output of the screen. So what is the combination of the red and green? So whatever the combination will be there, that we get the in the output of the screen, that color traces we get in the phosphor screen. So the mainly we get colors of orange and blue, so orange and yellow. Okay, so let's talk about the merits and demerits of the beam penetration technique. So merits, it is inexpensive, means it is not expensive. So if we talk about this shadow mask technique, it is whatever the cost is there, it is the half of that. So if the shadow mask technique is of the full price, if that price of half, it is half is beam penetration technique. So beam penetration technique is a little bit cheaper. Okay, if you talk about the demerits, means only four colors are here allowed here. So we see in it is the we get the in the phosphor green, means in the phosphor green we get the color as red, means if the electrons are slow, if we strike it on the red layer only, so we get the red traces on the output screen. If the electrons come and strike it on the if the electrons are fast, then it will penetrates and we get the green color on the phosphor screen. So if the electrons are coming in the middle speed, medium speed, so what will happen? The electrons come it on the strike it on the screen, so we get the combination of these two colors, that is red, orange and yellow. So basically we are getting total four colors, red, green and orange and yellow. So basically we are getting only four colors, okay, and it is not good in quality also, okay, it is not that much good in quality. So this is about the beam penetration technique. So I hope you have understood what is beam penetration technique and how it works. So if you have any kind of doubt, so please comment below, because the comment section is open for you all only. Please follow us on the Telegram, because we will give regular updates daily. Huge updates will be available on the Telegram. The link is in the description. If you want notes of this video, so our website link is also in the description. You can go it down, check it out. So you can notes, copy it down or write it down. So if you have not liked the video, please hit the like button and please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon also. See you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.